Yes, excellent. Clap to Hamza.
Hamza and the other first graders of Abu Nawar are having an English lesson.
Excellent.
At this Bedouin community in the West Bank near Jerusalem, the teachers try to hold classes as usual, despite the threats of eviction. Israeli NGOs like B'Tselem are mobilizing to support them.
Children are facing some difficulties because they walk to maybe 1 kilo or 2 kilo in a day to reach school.
Are they all from Abu Nawar or
yes,
from
surrounding communities? Yes, from here.
Okay. So all over Area C, which is the vast majority of the West Bank, which is where all the resources are that are needed for future development for the benefit of all residents of the West Bank, Israel enacts this policy that is designed to make life so difficult for Palestinians that they choose, quote unquote, to leave.
Every morning they wonder if there'll be a class or a classroom because of frequent demolitions here by Israeli authorities.
Last year, we applied to the Israeli court in Kfar Zion for a building permit. We built two classrooms for the third and fourth grades. But on the 4th of February, despite having a permission to build the classrooms, they came in at 5 a.m. and demolished them.
Like the nearby Bedouin village of Khan al Ahmar, Abu Nawar is also locked in a long-term conflict with Israel. In July, Israel demolished 9 houses. It's become a pattern. Demolish, rebuild, demolish.
So just behind me is part of a very substantial major Israeli settlement, Ma'ale Edomim. It is very close. It was designed, you know, right at the outset as a physical block. And the significance is to continue and entrench and solidify the process of disconnecting East Jerusalem from the rest of the West Bank.
The process of disconnecting East Jerusalem from the West Bank plays out here in this desert area where Abu Nawar is located. An area just 12 kilometers square between Jerusalem and the Jewish settlement of Ma'ale Adumim. It's called by its map name, E1, and it's the last corridor of land that connects the Palestinians in the north and the south of the West Bank.
E1 is considered to be a doomsday settlement. It's not just another settlement because it is of enormous strategic importance. If E1 were to be built, it in and of itself would kill the two-state solution. Why? Because it would drive a wedge through the entire West Bank, basically cutting it in half.
Israeli construction here would also isolate the West Bank from East Jerusalem, which Palestinians want as their capital.
If E1 were to be built, it would be impossible to integrate a Palestinian capital in East Jerusalem. Until now, E1 has not been built. But the forward movement on the displacement of the people in Khan al Ahmar is a clear indication that the construction of E1 is being seriously contemplated.
Israel plans to evict the Bedouin community of Khan al Ahmar, located just outside the E1 zone. Danny Tirza is chairman of the Kfar Adumim settlement, which overlooks them. He claims Israel will not build anything on the site once the Bedouins are evicted. But nor does he want anyone other than Israel to build here.
We have to have the control on this area, not only for security reasons, then from the reasons that I told you before, the reasons that we believe that this is our homeland. The Jews are coming here not because they want to take property from others. We are coming here because this is our homeland.
Danny Tirza was part of the Israeli team negotiating with the Palestinians. For 14 years, he was the team's mapmaker. After that, he became builder of the barrier separating Jerusalem from the West Bank.
The fence is more expensive than the wall.
The fence is not built to separate East Jerusalem from the West Bank. It's only a security line. When we'll come back to the negotiation table, of course there will be other concerns and the line will be changed. But this line today is only a security line. Israel says that this is not a border.
This doesn't convince the Palestinians. In addition to the progressive nibbling away of land by the Jewish settlements, they see this wall as a means to enlarge the boundaries of Jerusalem, to integrate it into the Israeli state, and to cut it off from the West Bank. Palestinians say it gradually extinguishes the hope that they will one day have a state, with East Jerusalem as its capital.